course, the Coast Guard has been targeted for hacking their websites, and it's been alarming. Why are the hackers targeting these agencies? It's just merely ransomware, if I'm not mistaken, or testing the vulnerabilities of these websites and security as well.
The target of the hackers are government agencies, because these agencies are the most vulnerable in terms of maintenance, in terms of security. So, for example, the PhilHealth was hacked because their endpoint security was expired. So if their endpoint security then was up to date, so hindi sila sana ma-hack. One of the reasons was that the procurement process in the government is really slow. So their software was expired in April. They've been requesting for updates. They were requesting for new software. So na-hack sila September, and it was still old endpoint security that they were using.
Outdated
yung mga security. So, for example, last time it was DOST.
Yes.
DOST was hacked, and around 25 terabytes of data were deleted. So how big is 25 terabytes? If you will print all the data on a short bond paper, pagkatapos pagpapatung-patungin mo siya, it will reach up to 10 floors. That's how big that 25 terabytes of data is. So again, ang nangyari dito sa DOST, it was I think it was a human error, because they had put online their source codes nasa online and publicly accessible. So good thing now we have the National Cybersecurity Plan 2028. So with this executive order signed by the president, I think we'll have more security, and our government agencies will be more secure, because it's mandated there that each agency will have their own computer emergency response team, or CERT. So, yes. Ibig sabihin ito, they will have more people to take care of our cybersecurity. Unlike now, wala talaga, kulang tayo ng mga tao. Because if, halimbawa yung sa DOST, it was hacked. So the people who responded were people from DOST, DICT pa. So they don't have their team at the premises.
Now, Mr. Art, everyone, well, basically all of us are vulnerable to scams, to fraud, right? To at least credit card fraud. We encounter this every day. And as an analyst and as a tech expert, I know that you've been, pushing for this advocacy always about education and information. But at least for the ones, you know, that are in a vulnerable state, you know, everybody has its own state. Maybe one is stressed, one has so many things to think about, and that split second of vulnerability, or maybe not thinking so much, it can be, you know, a cause for being a victim of a scam. What are the things that we do on a daily basis that may put us at risk?
So scammers are really, really sophisticated in doing the attacks now. So pag sa Pilipinas ka, what they do is that they will send the message very early in the morning. So when you receive that at 4 or 5 a.m. asking you to click the link, at kagigising mo pala, of course, what will you do is just, okay, I'll click the link, not knowing that it's a phishing link. And then they will ask for your details. So what we need to do is to be really careful in clicking these links, because this is the number one reason why our accounts are being compromised. These phishing links, we give our information, we give our login, we give our password. Your banks will never ask you for those things. GCash and PayMaya and Maya will not ask you for those things. So we need really to change our attitude in looking at these things. So dapat po tayo magduda. So be skeptical in everything that you receive online, especially the things you receive or you read on Facebook. If it involves money, if it involves information, scam po yan. Please be careful. Do not follow those links or do not believe those people telling you that you need to log in or you need to send something, even if those persons are saying that they're your friends. Your friends, well, they might be hacked. So their accounts could have been compromised. So you need to be very careful in replying to those messages, especially if it involves money and information.
Yes. Of course, we do transact online for our needs, not just the shopping needs, but of course, the daily needs in terms of the platforms on e-commerce. How can we mitigate those risks, especially our credit card details are saved, our information are saved, it's all out there.
So we always tell our friends when we give talks and, seminars about cybersecurity, na dapat, una mong gawin, magduda ka. So magduda, anything that you receive online, especially now that they have been really sophisticated with the use of AI and deepfakes, that they mix when you see wrong grammar in the emails, you really know that, wala na to. This is a scam. But now, using ChatGPT, using generative AI, the scammers now can really create or craft an email that is targeted to each individual. So kaya mag-ingat po tayo, hindi po masamang one, magduda po tayo. And of course, it's really important na magsumbong tayo. So you always report if someone attempted to scam you or you have been a scam victim. We need to report because if we will not report, the next victim could be our loved ones. So we need to remember that if you're a victim of cybercrime, it's like being a victim of COVID. The first thing that the first persons that will be affected are those persons near to us.
So contact tracing din, Sir Art. Contact tracing.
We need to contact trace also. So kasi yung sa mga Facebook Messenger. So when someone asks you or someone who you did not see for a really long time asks you for your number or for your email, and then you will give it to them, and then they will say, "Oh, I will add you to my address book, but I will be sending you OTP. I will be sending you code from Facebook so that I can add you." Naku, wag po kayong maniniwala because that's not the code for Facebook. That's not the code for them, but a code of your account. So what they will do is that your account or your number, they will just put it to the forget password on Facebook. And then, it will give them the list of names na merong ganung numbers. And Facebook will send the login na code to you. And if you will give that to the scammers or someone who asks you for that code, he can now take over your Facebook accounts. That's how easy it is to take over a Facebook account for the clueless users. Kasi yes, nagbibigay kagad. Oh, so we really need to be careful. If someone is asking you anything like code or phone number or even email address, be sure that that person is the one who asked for it. Baka na-compromise yung accounts nila.
Yes. Thank you, Art, for our deeper dive into deepfake videos, AIs, and of course, added tips in our everyday lives to avoid these scams. But lastly, but quickly, Art, you are the co-convener of Scam Watch Pilipinas, and cybersecurity is highly close to your heart, and of course, your advocacy. What is this, and how will this help society in Scam Watch Pilipinas?
Scam Watch Pilipinas is a movement that helps educate the public about the dangers of cybercrime. So that's our only purpose. We will educate people on how to be safe online because, well, really sad to say, cybercrime is a great equalizer. There were doctors, lawyers, teachers, school principals, tindera sa palengke, janitors. They are all became a victim of cybercrime. So dapat we need to educate these people, not only the masa but also the educated ones, because they're the ones really vulnerable for cybercrime. So please go to scamwatchpilipinas.com and volunteer so that we could educate the public, we could educate the Filipino people, especially the senior citizens and the children, about the dangers of the internet because of the cybercrime.
All right. Thank you very much and happy weekend to cybersecurity analyst Art Samaniego. Thank you so much for your time here on Head Start.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sir Art.